now, class, let us start with the discussion of the question answers of the chapter packing. Now, as we have read the chapter, any doubt now to any student? It's fine, everything is clear to you all. So now let us start with the chapter discussion of the question answers. How many characters are there in the narrative? Name them. Yes. Very good. Four characters. Sit down, Vatsal. Which four characters? Yes. It was the three friends, right? George, Harris, as well as the dog, Monjo, Morency. Right. Now, next afterwards, why did the Meher has come on that day in the class? She's actually online or offline?
Offline.
Okay. Why did the narrator Jaram volunteer to do the packing? Yes, Archita. Sit down, Vatsal, please. Sit down. Very good. Very good. Very good. So, why he volunteered to do the packing? He volunteered to do the packing because he was confident about his packing skills. Or he also felt that he was the best packer in the world, and rather than his other two friends, that is George and Harris. And this has been finally proved at the end too. Okay. That he was better packer than George and Harris. Okay, and he intended that his other two friends would do packing under his supervision. But opposite happened to that. He had to do the packing, right? Okay. Third question, how did George and Harris react to this? Did Jaram like their reaction? Yes. Okay, yes, Lavlina. Yes. So how they wanted George and Harris, how they reacted? They were yes, they have shown very relaxed attitude. They were quite happy that they are to sit free. Actually, they want to sit free. Okay, right. And okay. And ultimately how they sat down as George sat by yes, right. By cocking his legs on the table, and the other one sat in a relaxing chair or in an easy chair. And did Jaram like this? No, Jaram did not like this. Okay. He felt irritated. Yes, he felt irritated, but actually, what was his intention? That he would supervise the entire job. Okay. He got irritated because of their slacking as well as relaxing attitudes. What was Jaram's real intention when he offered to pack? What was his real intention? Yes?
Jaram believed that he was the best packer in the world, so he volunteered to pack the bags. But the reaction he got was not what he intended. What he had meant was that he should pause the job and that Harris and George should potter around following his
Yes, yes. Very good. So he wanted to boss the job actually, and he thought that his other two friends, what they would do, they would just follow his instructions. Why he thought so? Because he thought that he is the best packer and he would supervise the job only, right? So that he would only supervise that job. So it is because of this reason he wanted to just, you can say, instruct them how to do the packing and would tell them, now put this thing, now put that thing, okay? What did Harry say after the bag was shut and strapped? And why do you think he wanted till then to ask? What did Harry say after the bag was shut and strapped? Yes, what did Harry say? Yes, Archita. Yes. Very good answer. Very good answer. Archita, you are writing on your own? Good. Try to write on your own, whatever, whosoever is speaking. So now, so what was actually, what did Harry say? Harry said that whether he has packed the boots in or not. Okay. So what was his real intention? His real intention was just to irritate him, right? Annoy him, to irritate him, because throughout the process while he was packing, he was watching carefully and intently. And just at the moment he has strapped the pack, he reminded him whether you have packed, whether he had packed the boots in or not. And this really irritated him, as he was already tired because of that also. Right? So. Yes, it was senseless love. And next question. What horrible idea occurred to Jerem a little later? Yes, Ramni?
When Jerem unstrapped the bag, packed the boots, a horrible idea occurred to him. He wondered whether he had packed his toothbrush or not.
Yes.
He was thinking about having his toothbrush packed every time he went on a trip.
Very good. So actually, what horrible idea came to him, whether he has packed his toothbrush in or not, because this is one of the horrible idea that always haunts him. Okay, and most of the times when he is going for a journey, he is always haunted by the thought of the idea, or he is always haunted by this fact that whether he has packed his boots in or not. Packed his toothbrush in or not, and he had to run upstairs in order to take the toothbrush again, and ultimately wrap in a handkerchief and would put back into his pocket and would run to the railway station. Right. Next is, where did Jerem finally find the toothbrush? Where? Yes, it was, he has unpacked the bag again. He has taken out all the things. He has found various things, and for George and Harris, he has found theirs 18 times. Okay, he said so. Right? But for his, when it was not found, lastly it was found, it was in one of the boots, and finally he felt relaxed. So, why did Jerem have to reopen the packed bag? Yes. Toothbrush. And when the third time he has asked whether he has packed the... Yes, he has left his spectacles, and one more time when he was reminded of the thought that whether the soap was in or not, he least bothered about it because he was tired of packing at that time, as he has opened up the bag already 3 times and it was really very difficult for him to pack the bag again and again. Soap, see here. Yes, right. That he is least bothered. Next question, what did George and Harris offer to pack and why? What did they, yes, Purvi, tell me. Purvi will tell me. What did George and Harris offer to pack and why? Hampers. Okay. So they offered to pack the hampers. They were happy to pack. Actually, they also wanted to display their packing skills. They also wanted to display their packing skills, and it is because of this reason. Ayan, what are you writing? Okay, so sit down, please, Purvi. So he has offered to pack the hampers, as they also wanted to deliver their, show off their packing skills. They wanted to display their packing skills. They wanted to prove that they are better packers than Jerem. And was it proved later on? No. It was not at all proved. Okay? Yes. They are the worst packers. Jerem is the... Okay. Right. So next, while packing the hamper, George and Harris do a number of foolish and funny things. Stick the statements that are true. They started with breaking a cup. They also broke a plate. Not mentioned. Anna? They squashed a tomato. They trod on the butter. They stepped on a banana. They put things through. They stepped on things through. They packed pictures at the bottom. They upset almost. They were very good. Next is, why does Jerem say was Montmorency's ambition in life, and what do you think of Montmorency and why? Okay, you speak.
Ambition in life was to get a pay and be sworn at. He believed that his pay would not be wasted if someone would shout at him, throw things on his head and make people mad. To get somebody to stumble over him and curse at him steadily for an hour was his highest aim and object. And when he had succeeded in accomplishing this, his conceit becomes quite unfair.
Yes. It means that Montmorency was always adding on the trouble. Okay. Okay. He was also, of course, a troublemaker. He's adding on the trouble, and he is, you can say, of the same nature to add on more and more trouble. And until and unless he is not adding on trouble, or until and unless he is not creating some chaos in the work that has been going on, he feels that the day is not complete. Moreover, or his conceit is not fulfilled. Okay. In the other words. And if a person would not get irritated through a fry pan or anything at his head and would drive him away, he again thought that the day is finally not complete. So whenever Jerem, George and Harris, they were packing and they were looking for the things, their hands were always outreached with his damp nose only. So ultimately, he is intruding in all the things. He has taken the lemons as rats and he has killed three of them, and finally they have to drive him away and hit him on his head, and ultimately he sat quietly. Okay. Yes, he was of course creating mess, and a lot of mess is always being created by him, by Montmorency. Okay. Now next, discuss in groups and answer following questions in 2 to 3 paragraphs. Means long answers. Of the three, Jerem, George and Harris, who do you think is the best or worst packer? Support your answer with details from the text. Okay, who is the best packer?
Jerem.
Of course, it has been proved that out of the three friends, Jerem is the best packer, because he was doing it in a responsible way. He actually has displayed the responsible behavior, as he has not only packed his things also, but also of the other two friends. Okay, and yes, he has not created any mess while packing, as he was the only one to pack. Okay, he has arranged all the things and in order to put them into the bag, and he has a concerned attitude also. Okay, because he had not packed only his things but that of his friends also. Okay, and at last he is also able to recorrect his mistakes or the problem that has been created. For example, you know that when he has packed the bag for the first time, then what happened when he was reminded by George whether he has packed the boots in? He reopened his bag and packed the boots. Okay. Later on, it means that he always takes stress off the things. Okay. This is the reason that the toothbrush idea is the only one that haunts him often. Okay. So what? Organized manner he was packing the things, of course, there is no doubt. Okay, he was of course responsible. This is the reason why he has completed the packing. Okay, and he alone has performed the task single-handedly. Okay, he alone has performed the entire task single-handedly. And then what happened? He has opened the bag 3 times. Okay, in order to satisfy himself also, as well as his friends, that everything is packed up to the mark and there is no mistake to be done. But on the other way, when the two friends, that is George and Harris, what they have to do? They have to only, okay, they have to pack the hamper. So what they have ultimately done? They have only created mess and trouble only. Nothing else they have done. For packing the hampers, first of all, they have spilled the things all over on the floor. Okay, then ultimately they spilled salt on everything, right? Trod on the butter, squashed the potatoes by putting heavy things over them, and then they scooped the tomatoes with the help of broken. Yes, they have started by breaking a capon. Okay. Yes, they have put pies at the bottom. Very good. And yes. Right. Very good. Yes, they stepped over the food items. They have trotted over the butter. Okay, then Harry sat on the butter. It was stuck at his back and he was moving round and round the room. And finally, when they found it, it was really a silly mistake on their part. Okay, so ultimately, whatever they have done, it was completely a chaos till the end. And that chaos has been repeated throughout their packing, for which time it is going on. And ultimately, their packing skills are not being displayed in an appropriate manner. They were not at all good packers. They were good at only making trouble and creating chaos and irritating others. And moreover, they are irresponsible, quite irresponsible also. How they were irresponsible? Because when Jerem was packing, okay, he tried actually to boss the job, and his real intention was to supervise the skill of packing, okay, to supervise their packing. But actually what happened, they sat in a relaxing manner. George sat in an easy chair and Harry cocked his legs on the table. So that was just, you can say, not any kind of concerned attitude was shown by them. Okay, non-concerned attitude was shown by them. So out of these, on the basis of all these, you can say facts from the chapter, it is very well weighed as well as displayed that Jerem finally came out to be a good packer as well as a responsible packer. He proved himself. Yes, George and Harris, they were the worst packers. Okay, right. Incompetent. Okay, right. Two persons were doing, still chaos was produced. Right? These all textbook questions you have to do. First to 9, 10th not to be done in notebook, and these question number. Second main part, Montmorency one, and now these third one. All do you have to do. Okay, the first ones, question number 1 to 9, you can write down in 2 to 3 lines. Okay, and these one, later ones, long ones. So we will get 4 marks question also. For that, you should be prepared now. Okay, earlier so you were not in that race because you are going through MCQs. But now this time, be careful. Yes. 100 words enough. Next, how did Montmorency contribute to the packing? This I have completely discussed in question number main 2. Okay, how did Montmorency? Okay, you will give all the examples. Sat on the things. Very good. Put his leg in the jam. Okay, lemons were rats and killed 3 of them. Added to the chaos created by Jerem, because whenever they are extending their hand or reaching their hand, what was coming? It was a damp nose of Montmorency that comes, and he feels that the day is not completed or the conceit is not fulfilled unless someone would throw the things at him or hit him at the head. Finally, when he has created utter chaos, then what happened? Harris. He has thrown a fry pan at his head, and finally he sat down. Okay, so all these examples you will write down in the answer. So the last question is, do you find this story funny? Yes, of course. What are the humorous elements? I told you that this story is replete with various kinds of humorous elements since the start. Okay, so it started a bit when Jerem was packing, it started a bit in a serious tone, but soon this has been overtaken by a humorous one. Okay, and one couldn't stop himself laughing while reading this chapter, and we students, and you can say we also enjoyed a lot while reading it. It is just because of the fun and humor that has been added into this story. So what are the incidents? Let us recapitulate at once. What are the different incidents? Role of Mentor Montmorency. The most funniest one is when Montmorency has taken the lemons as rats and was hunting in the hamper for them, right? And butter incident is one of the funniest one. Yes, they were scooping out the tomatoes with the help of a teaspoon, right? Okay. pies at the bottom. Yes. Put butter inside a kettle also. Okay, and then finally it was not coming out the way they were trying to get it out. It was really a funny moment. Okay, and when in the starting also, when you can say that George reminded Jerem whether he has packed his boots in. This although evoked anger, but it also evoked a tinge of laughter in us that he tries to irritate his friends. Okay, so yes, he was making fun of him, right? Okay, so you will write down now on your own. Okay, so I hope that now the chapter is very much clear to you all. Some of the extra questions I will also discuss in the class tomorrow, just for your reference, so that you can have a deep insight into the chapter. No, you need not to do. Okay?